Hi everyone, my name is Leah and I'm a 3D motion design freelancer. Today I am wearing a bomber jacket because we're going to be talking about 3D modeling a P-40 Warhawk plane. So I actually have some images of this plane up so you can see what they look like. But they're from World War II, and they have these painted faces on them, which I've always thought were really cool. I've always enjoyed seeing these at air shows. I also felt really inspired while 3D modeling this of a little bit of history. Disney had designed a character called a Fifinella while working on the story with Roald Dahl, and yeah, it's a great story. It's called The Gremlins, and I suggest checking it out. And there's a character in there, and it's called a Fifinella, and Fifinellas are female gremlins that help serve. Well, they help the Air Force. And I actually have one on my bomber jacket, if you can see it right here. So they have wings and horns. And they were the mascot for women that served in World War II. They were called WASPs. Women Air Force Service Pilots was what it stood for. But it's just a cool piece of history, and that was the inspiration for the plane I had 3D modeled, and I'll run a clip of it right now. I actually worked on this for Endless Engines, the competition. My goal really wasn't to win, it was just to have fun 3D modeling a plane. So that was my main motivation of doing it, and I had a friend doing it too, so we did it together. Yeah, we both competed. Yeah, but here's the plane that I had 3D modeled. I had textured on the face and everything and added on a Fifinella. And I added WASP 199 to remember the women that served in World War II. This was the first time in history that female pilots were allowed to serve in the Air Force. So I think that's a cool bit of history. I made the rudder and different parts of the plane separate so that they can actually be rigged and animated. And something else cool about this plane is that the wheels actually fold up into the wing. But I thought what would be really good today is to just tell you a little bit about my process and how I had gone about 3D modeling this. So, let me see if I can find this. I used this as a reference, so this is really helpful. It's a 360 view of what the cockpit looks like on the inside, and I actually took screenshots from here in order to texture it, and it was a great reference because I could actually see what does the seat look like inside, and I did change some things. This is more of a steel type of material, and I liked a little bit more of a bronzish kind of look to it, so I had changed some of the colors in here. But this was how I had textured the cockpit, was I took some screenshots from this so that I could have an accurate look of all the instruments on the inside, and that was really helpful. So yeah, I strongly suggest finding good references and creating an image board. It's really helpful. For 3D modeling this, So I want to show you a little bit of the method that I used for 3D modeling this. This was, I had three planes and I put a front view here of the plane, a top view on this plane here, and a right view or side view of the plane. So then I could use these to 3D model, and I used textures of the orthographic view of the plane. And orthographic views are a straight on view of something, a product or a vehicle or anything being manufactured, but it takes out all perspective so that when you're looking at it, it isn't being distorted at all by perspective. If you use different types of cameras or focal lengths, it's going to distort, different kinds of lenses. It could distort how something looks. So orthographic views are very accurate in how they show something. And if I press the middle button here, I can click on any one of these views and I can 3D model just referencing the right side, just the top view, or just the front view. And I'm just flipping through these by hitting the middle button on my mouse. And these are what I used to 3D model this historical plane without having it right in front of me. I wanted it to be accurate, but I knew I couldn't do that just from photos. It would distort the plane. And you can find images like this in manuals. You can find it. You can sometimes find orthographic views online. If you are making up your own, if you are making up your own kind of vehicle or object that you want a 3D model, something that I recommend is actually sketching it. You can sketch your own ideas in orthographic views, bring them in, place them on a plane, your sketches, scan them into your computer, and use those as a reference for 3D modeling, because you really don't have to guess while you're doing it. You can get things really accurate inside of Cinema 4D, which I think is really amazing. So I just want to show you a little bit of my process behind 3D modeling that, and maybe that will help you 3D model your own ideas. And if you have 3D modeled anything, I'd absolutely love to see it. So if you send me a link in the comments of your work, or if you were in Endless Engines as well, I'd love to see what you had worked on for Endless Engines. This was what I worked on for the Endless Engines competition, and it was so much fun to do. The results haven't come in yet, so I don't even know what happened yet, but I think it's a great learning experience to do it, and I was really more of just doing it for fun. I have another friend that was competing in this, and it's just a great experience, and I love 3D modeling planes, so of course I'm going to do it. And if you found this helpful and you'd like to see more videos like this, I also cover different 3D modeling tools inside of Cinema 4D on YouTube. If you'd like to see those, please hit like and subscribe. That helps me out, and you'll also be notified the next time I come out with a video. Thank you so much for watching.